loved to play in the snow. But in the town of Centerville, not one flake of snow had fallen. With the winter half over, some children had even started to pack their sleds away. They were beginning to believe that they would never see snow again.
Thank you.
they were dropping a $100 prize. All the newspapers carried the story of the boy and his amazing snowman, and one man in particular took great interest in eating Robin and Hattie. His name was Pretty Fast Tom, and he was always looking for a new get-rich-quick scheme.
Thank you.
Spending all of his time in the freezer now. In fact, he didn't seem very happy anymore. And Robin didn't seem to have any time in his schedule for doing the things he liked so much.
Oh, well, that's too bad.
Hi, Robin.
Robin could go back to being happy again. So after Reddy gave me a letter, he ran off in the middle of the night.
Thank you.
he was still combing through the papers looking for a new get-rich-quick scheme. And in case you're wondering what happened, I just happened to have a letter right here. It says, "Dear boys and girls, I'm having a great time resting up for next winter when I'll be making a guest appearance in my very own backyard. So remember, when you build your snowman, be sure to talk to him. And if he answers, you'll know it's me. So until the first snowfall of next year, have a happy."
Oh. said we're going to see King's Palace.
What?
The King's Palace.
Where?
That's what I'm asking. What's the star got to do with the King's Palace?
We're following the star because it points to the King.
Who is the King?
Will he be friends?
He's sure to be. He's one of us, a king. He'll just be the head king.
Not just head king. This is the King of Kings. God, creator's very own son.
You're right, Mel. I'm glad we're bringing these gifts with us. So am I. Don't shut the king's palace without gifts, especially this king. Say, isn't it good to be off those dumpy, lumpy camels?
Well, if you don't quit talking and get moving again, the king will return before we get there.
King's entire.
Where's the next rest stop?
What?
Rest stop.
No, thank you. I am stopped.
Where's the next rest stop?
Jericho.
Jericho? I have it right here. Those humans always have legends.
We carry your
he aligned to a city named Jerusalem.
Other than that, this is confirmed. He negotiates and rescues all the false humans I know from the camels.
Don't you believe it? Hey, which way are we headed?
West towards Jerusalem.
It just might be this is the king we're going to see. One of us might be asked to carry it.
That's it. Of course.
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
Uh-oh, this is bad. Take your sleep. Well, Thad, let's get these dumb animals moving.
We have three old kings walking around the desert, chasing a star, looking for a king. We don't know who he is, what he looks like, or where his kingdom is. Now I ask you, who's calling who dumb?
Do you have any noise from the camels?
No! I don't hear a thing! But if I did, it would probably be from them camels.
Never mind, let's get moving. We can't lose the star. I wonder what the king will look like. Feeling. I mean, all the stars around me began to stare at me.
I know it feels like there's nothing.
I thought my bees needed spitting or something. So while I just hung there feeling foolish, I had a sort of vision. I was chosen by our creator to be a special pointer star.
What's a pointer sister?
Frankly, I didn't know either. But our creator told me he's sending a special king down on Earth to show the people how he wants them to live. And I'm going to be the special pointer star who will show where the king will be.
You know where the king will be?
Not yet, but I will. And the creator said when the time draws near, we'll all be especially bright bloomers.
We will be eyes to be lighter and brighter?
Right.
My stars.
Could it be possible that us will be chosen to be the king?
Hey, that's a boring thought. Stars are high, exalted, famous, and iron.
I suppose anything is possible, but I doubt it. I understand who wants him on Earth among the people. However, he did call him a bright morning star.
He might choose a star.
Hey, no, shepherds, animals are staring at me.
Where?
Down there, on that side of those hills.
Let me get my binoculars.
Man, you have bright eyes. That's a long way off.
Not that far away. Here.
What are those white things?
Those are animals and goats.
And those skinny little things?
Those are humans.
So that's what a human looks like.
We're certainly better looking. Maybe one of us will be the king.
Pure being, the brightest light.
our Creator, because His love for them.
Do our shepherds love us? Make sure to ask us sometimes. Some of them do, some don't. That's the problem. But I can definitely know.
What can I land you?
Oh, Billy, well, I can drop you. Oh, sorry, Mr. Drop. People are like animals. They need a lot of love. I have been supposed to do, but we have to try to love ourselves, even those who have treated us in kindness.
Yeah, I told you, Arthur, don't. Who would love animals? For centuries, our Creator has chosen us to determine the staff of life, the new king is going to be a lamb. The scriptures tell the Lamb of God, and this new lamb comes, we won't have to give our lives anymore. He is going to be a blessing for everyone.
Yeah, that's right. Who will be a lamb to be the Lamb of God?
Yeah.
you don't need a friend. I'm an angel.
Wake up, everyone! Did you hear the angels?
You didn't expect us to sleep to bed, did you?
What's going on?
Some angels were singing.
This
is an angel.
Nobody's an angel all the time.
We are.
The king has arrived.
He has?
Where?
Here in the city of David.
I knew it. This was like...
See him over there in the manger?
Why, Jacob, it's just a baby.
How can he look after us?
Keep a sheep he'll take care of.
Everyone's expecting this.
Yes, we know.
I wonder where he is.
Thank you. very stars seem to be speaking. Remember, all creatures, the sun, the moon, the stars, should worship him. Him gives life to all of us.
I have always thought we were great kings, but before him, we are simply three weak kings. He is great.
He is truly King of Kings.
We've always been told that if we see him,
He is expecting you.